Hello friends, hope you are doing well. Do you know that Alexander the Great was defeated by a sannyasi in India? Yes, we all know that Alexander conquered so many countries, he won so many battles, but in India he got defeated by a sannyasi or a saint. Hello friends, my name is Arun Bhardwaj and I am a success coach. Today I am going to share with you the story of a sannyasi who defeated the great Alexander. When Alexander was planning to go back from India, he thought to himself, why should I not take an Indian sannyasi with me? I can show it to the people of Greece. The Indian sannyasis have a lot of mystic power, they have an aura, they have so much knowledge and wisdom, and the people of Greece would love to see such a person. So he tells his army, go and get me an Indian sannyasi who I can take along with. They searched and found a sannyasi who was very wise and known in his area. And they decided to take him to Alexander. He told the sannyasi, I'm going to take you to Greece with me. So get ready and we will start the journey tomorrow. The sannyasi said, sorry Alexander, I cannot go with you. He said, how dare you defy my wish? I am the great Alexander and no one can dare to defy my wish. The sannyasi said, you may have conquered the world, you may be a great emperor, but as far as I am concerned, I will not go to Greece with you. Alexander was shocked. He told his army people to tie the sannyasi on a chariot. And once he was tied up, he said, now you realize you have no choice, you will be going with me. The sannyasi said, Alexander, you may be able to take my body with you to Greece, but my mind, it will shut down as soon as it goes outside India. So are you going to show my body to your people, or you want to show my knowledge, my wisdom to the people of Greece? Alexander immediately realized that he was making a big mistake, and he told his army to free the sannyasi. So that is how a sannyasi defeated the great Alexander. The moral of the story is, in any situation, under any circumstances, you always have the power to choose your response. We have already shared with you the story of Viktor Frankl, who was captured by the Nazis. He was put in a concentration camp. But he survived only because he did not subjugate his mind to the Nazis. He stayed positive. He kept thinking about the things he will do when he comes out of concentration camp. So this is what we all need to learn, that whatever the situation, whatever the circumstance, we always have the power to choose what is best for us. I hope you liked the story. If you did, press the like button, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon, and I'll come back to you with another story. Until then, stay safe, stay healthy. Goodbye.